Welcome to the MSRA Back to the 50s here at the Minnesota State Fairgrounds for our 40th annual car show with over 12,000 custom cars, 1964 and older. Enjoy the next video, and I'd hope to see you here.
Welcome to U.S. Classic Muscle Cars. Thanks for being here. Please enjoy the show.
Man, I love all these old cars.
So pretty, right?
I know.
Hello, my name is Norm. The 56 Chev came out of California. This is my third 56. And I had plans, if I ever found another one, I was gonna build a trailer. And I had that dream for longer than 10 years. But I got the car first, and I was able to save parts from when I first was putting it together. I put enough parts away, at least I thought. But then I found somebody else that knew where there was a couple of junkyards that had all kinds of parts. So investigating them, I was able to find other parts that I needed. And I ran across this one guy at a car show, and I got to talking to him. And he knew about what I was looking for, and I couldn't figure out how he knew. He said, "We have a mutual friend." So he gave me the guy's name. I said, "Yeah, he's a member of the car club." And he says, I've heard, he's been talking. He says, "You need some help looking for parts because you want to build a trailer." And I says, "Yeah, I want to put a trailer with the front end and the back end of the car together so it looks like it's coming and going." And he just kind of laughed at me. And so he says, "I know somebody else who could probably help you." So he gave me name of two guys, and I went to check both of them. And one guy says, "Yeah," he says, I heard you're a good friend of such and such." I says, "Yeah." I says, "He mentioned the fact about what you're up to." And he says, "I think I got something that can help you." He says, "I got a couple of 56s and a couple of 55s out behind the barn." He says, "I'm sure I got something that maybe you could use." So I says, "Okay." I went out to his barn. Up to his house. And I looked, and there he was. He had two 55s and three 56s. I says, "Yeah," I said, "I can use this, that, and everything, two fenders." And I said, "I can even use the hood." Because the hood that I had, I took off the car. It had a bow in it. And so with measuring everything, I said, "Something has to be cut." So I had to cut. I cut the hood, I measured the hood and so forth. So I cut about 2.5 inches off the back of the hood, and then made it so I could fit it down in. And then I took clamps and clamped the fender and the hood together on both sides and fitted everything. And then I start tack welding different parts of it, going up and down slow so I wouldn't warp anything. And I did it to both sides. And I used to work at one company, that metal place, and I made patterns of what I needed, and they would cut and bend the parts for me. And I'd come home and I would start working on it a little at a time every night. Neighbors kept watching me. And they finally come over, they said, "Just keep doing what you're doing." He says, "We've seen your stuff after it's been done, but now we get a chance to actually see you doing something."
Right. Put it to action, right.
Yeah, so I said, "Well, that's what I'm doing. I built it on my patio. And I put it on horses first to line things up, get measurements." And I wound up using the original hood that I had by cutting it where I wanted to cut it I measured it twice, three times, and I cut it on my first measurement, and it fit right in where it belonged.
So here's a question for you. Now, so if you win a car show award, and I'm sure you do, do you get a trophy and a half?
No, I haven't got a half yet.
There you go. Cool.
The idea for 10 years, and I finally found parts.
That is so cool. That is so cool.
Yeah.
That is neat.
I'd say about four or five bodies worth, right?
There you go.